time now for everybody's favorite guessing game, What's My Line? Brought to you by Remington Rand, makers of the world's number one electric shaver, the Remington. Now, let's all play What's My Line?
Now, let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the popular Broadway columnist whose Voice of Broadway appears in the New York Journal American and papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Thank you. And now I'm very happy to welcome back to the program someone that we're always pleased to have visit us because he's so nice and such a good game player. He's the star of his own show on this network every weekday, and he's substituting for Fred Allen tonight, Robert Q. Lewis.
Thank you, darling.
I wish I were a cricket. If I were a cricket, I could introduce Arlene Francis to my left by simply saying...
And if I were a boy cricket, I'd say the same thing about you. And someone tells me that they play What's My Line around the house quite a bit, and What's My Line has come out with a game that you can buy at stores very soon, so that you'll have it right handy there to play with if you'd like to. That's What's My Line. And the fellow that knows a lot about that is the columnist publisher on my left, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
Thank you. And on my left, of course, is a man who is not only a news analyst and panel moderator, but one of the greatest piccolo players of our time, John Charles Daly.
Just to get the record straight, I can't even play a bazoo, let alone a piccolo. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. Once again tonight, some very interesting occupations, some nice people who brought them here. We're going to try to fool the panel with them. I think we're going to have some success. We'll have a famous guest challenger for these experts a bit later on, but I think it's time for my friends now to meet the first challenger whose line has to be spotted. So will you sign in, please, sir? Raymond? Raymond Fadden, is that right, sir?
Arlene Fadden?
You nervous?
Not a bit.
Not a bit? Oh, no, I forgot all about that. Don't say any more. Where are you from, Mr. Fadden?
From New York.
Oh, from New York? Oh, fine. We try to give the panel a little help. With contestants, we like to give them a chance to see them close on, so to speak. So would you take a hike down there in front of the panel for me?
Well, Mr. Fadden.
Hi, Mr. Fadden.
Mr. Fadden?
Hi, Arlene.
All right, Mr. Fadden, right over here, if you will, and sit down next to me. I would ask you, first of all, if you're familiar with our scoring system. Do you know how we score this operation? Would you pull your chair in, please? And then I think all we need to do is let the folks at home and our friends here in the theater know exactly what your line is. Panel, Mr. Fadden is salaried. With that, let's begin the general questioning with Bennett Cerf.
Mr. Fadden, you're one of the most self-composed gentlemen we've had here in a long time. Do you perform a service of some kind?
May I interrupt just a minute? Mm-hmm. Would you lean forward a bit, sir? This is your microphone. It's all yours.
I do. Do people come to you to have this service performed?
Yes.
They do. Well, if I were to avail myself of your services, would you send my spirit soaring upward?
Possibly, yeah.
Possibly.
Possibly.
Very good answer. Possibly.
You mean you could also have the opposite effect on me?
Yes, it could.
Depending on circumstances.
That's right.
Would these services involve your touching me in any way?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you work for a profit-making organization?
I do.
Do you use anything besides just your hands in your work?
I do.
You use a variety of things rather than just one thing like a pencil?
No.
Wait a minute, we'll have to have a small conference.
Yes.
I think Mr. Fadden would be willing to agree just to obviate the possibility that we might be unfair or in any way, deny you the help that you properly should have. I think Mr. Fadden would be willing to agree that he uses, in your terms of reference, more than the one utensil.
Good to be back, Dorothy.
He's so kind to us, isn't he? Thank you, John. Mr. Fadden, do you work in an enclosure?
Yes, I do.
Does your work ever take you from one place in the enclosure to another?
Yes, ma'am.
Just a minute. May I have another question? Good deal. Yes, fine. All right, go ahead.
Does the enclosure ever move around?
No. That's two down a date to go, Mr. Lewis.
Thought it might be another bus driver.
You work in an enclosure that does not move around. Do you wear approximately what you are wearing now in your work, Mr. Fadden?
Yes, I do.
There's no special garb of any kind. Your work then is probably more mental than it would be physical. Is that correct?
It's more mental, yeah.
More mental.
Wait a minute.
John usually only has this many conferences with a pretty girl.
He's changed.
I think we'll have to give you a no on that, because there is a very substantial area of physical effort in this. That's three down and seven to go, Miss Francis.
May I guess that this enclosure is not an office building?
May you guess that?
Yes. It is not an office building.
You certainly may.
Oh, you were getting ready to say... Is it a place of entertainment of any kind, this place that you work?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Is there any product at all connected with what you do in this enclosure?
Not within our terms of reference.
May I tell you what my term of reference was?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I was thinking of animals.
Animals?
Now it's cleared up, isn't it?
Too bad.
Aren't you glad?
What on six to go, Mr. Sir?
Mr. Fadden, at the moment, there are some events taking place at a couple of baseball stadiums around New York. Would you have any connection whatever with the Honorable's pastime of baseball?
Yeah.
You have? Well, obviously...
Pee Wee Reese.
obviously, you're not an outfielder for the Yankees because you're hale and hearty.
Bennett.
Mr. Fadden, is your work done out of sight of the audience at a baseball game?
Out of the sight of the audience at a baseball game?
I mean, the crowd at the game wouldn't see you while you're performing this duty?
They see me perform the duty.
No, but they don't see you physically while you're performing.
They don't see you physically. Have you got anything to do with the scoring of the game? Are you one of the official scorekeepers of the World Series?
One of the official scorekeepers of the World Series? He is not. That makes it five down and five to go. Lucille Ball.
Do you have anything to do with the numbers coming up on the scoreboard every time the Dodgers get a home run?
Actually, I think you hit it right on the head. Mr. Fadden operates the scoreboard at Ebbets Field, which is done manually. As you know, it's not
He's
a big
been busy,
automatic.
Hasn't he?
He's been a very busy man. He's been so busy, we'll flip these all over. Anyway, but Mr. Madden, this must be fun, doing this in the World Series. Is this your first one, or have you done this before?
Sixth.
Your sixth World Series. Ever made a mistake up there that gave anybody any trouble?
It's a cinch on a single game.
It's a cinch on a single game. Well, thanks very much, Mr. Fadden. It's wonderful to have you with us. Good beginning. Let's see what you can do with another challenger. Will you sign in, please, sir? Victor G. Perry. Is that right, sir? Where are you from, Mr. Perry?
London, England.
From London? Big, isn't he? Huh? Wow. Golly day, you are a big man, huh? Well, from London, eh?
That's right.
Would you be good enough to let the panel have a closer look at you?
Certainly.
Thanks.
How do you do?
Shake hands gently, Mr. Perry.
Hello, Mr. Perry.
How do you do?
Hello, Mr. Perry.
All right, Mr. Perry, if you will, over here and sit down next to me. And I would ask you, as I do all, are you familiar with our scoring system?
Yes.
no answer, we flip a card, you know?
Fine, then let's let the people at home and our friends in the theater know exactly what your line is. Mr. Perry is self-employed. Let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
He's self-employed, and boy, he sure employs a lot. Well, Mr. Perry, you have the build for it. Is there anything physical about your job?
Yes.
Would it be considered a sport of any kind that you're involved with?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Perry, are you in any way connected with the entertainment business?
Yes.
You are?
Mm-hmm.
Do people come to see you do something?
Yes.
You're not connected in any way with the Doily Cart Company, are you?
No.
I said yes. You're not. Yes,
yes,
he's not connected.
Mr. Perry is not connected with the Doily Cart Company, no.
Do you have a deep, resonant voice. Do you ever raise it in song?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Ms. Kilgallen.
Well, when you perform, are you on stage in full view of the audience?
Yes and no.
Oh. Well, are you on stage, but not in full view of the audience?
Sometimes.
Wait a minute, I'm getting confused.
To think of Mr. Perry on stage and not in full view is difficult.
Yes.
All stage.
Is are you ever on stage when you are not in full view of the audience?
That's right.
That was the question, Miss Gallagher. We understood it perfectly. We'll now give her a no. That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Lewis.
You're sure you're not connected? I mean, I'm right in assuming you are not connected in baseball. I was thinking of the team, the House of Sir David.
Yes, I'm not connected with them.
You are an entertainer. You are sometimes in full view of your audience. There are times when you are not. Does your act have anything to do with the times when you are not in full view of your audience?
Yes, it does.
Ah, glad to hear that. Know that kind of an act? Does your act involve... Are you ever involved with members of the audience in your act?
Yes.
Is it a form of audience participation, then?
Yes.
It might be said that the audience participates, yes.
Well, then, you might... You might use members of the audience on stage after you had perhaps talked to them or would you go down into the audience to bring them up on stage?
Yes.
Is what you do with these people something they like to have done to them?
Yes and no.
Well, suppose you performed your act on me. And brought me up on stage. Would I be happy about it, or would I be... let me ask you this. Are you a hypnotist, by any chance?
Ah, that's four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Do you have anything to do with television at all?
Yes.
Do you ever say, in the commercials, soap, my lord?
No.
You don't do that?
Five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Perry, have you done most of your television work in England?
No.
Six down and four to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Are there any props in your act?
No.
Seven down and three to go, Mr. Lewis.
Is your act primarily a television act or a theater act? Is it
can't be answered yes or no. Which?
Oh, I beg your pardon. Is your act primarily an act which would be performed in a theater?
No.
It would be more often performed on television, then?
No.
Wait a minute.
Yes, I'm really hitting the jackpot.
I don't think he's told John what he does.
No. Mm-hmm.
You can't change it now, John.
No is right. Eight down and two to go, Miss Francis.
All right, now, it's gotten a little bit mixed up, so I do want to clarify. He does not perform in a theater.
The question as it was posed was, is this primarily an act performed in theater? No.
Ah. And then he said, is it an act primarily performed in television?
No.
And he said no.
Mm-hmm.
But you do work in television, don't you?
Yes.
And you are not an announcer?
I am not an announcer,
and
yes.
And you are not an announcer?
He doesn't. Really.
And you do not act? Do you... You don't use your voice in your job at all?
I do use my voice.
Well, that's...
to know.
Well, I know, but... Well, I didn't mean to ask it that way. He hypnotized me. You can get him a new line of work.
Nine out of one to go, Mr. Sir.
Now, Mr. Perry, you said earlier that your physical bulk played some part in what you did.
Yes.
Therefore, do you perform some feat of dexterity?
Yes.
Would you call it some kind of acrobatics?
Acrobatics? No. That's 10 down and no more to go.
Is he a dancer?
A dancer?
No.
Golly,
a
weightlifter.
One of those pickpockets.
One of those pickpockets? Yeah, one of those pickpockets is right. And he's right. I've had a wonderful time chatting with Mr. Perry before the show, and I think you'll all enjoy a story that he had to tell me. He has performed. It's an act, by the way, performed mostly in nightclubs, which is why you got to know on the theater and television. But he's performed before the Queen, and when he was all through, the Queen said, "Wonderful. It's a good thing you're honest." But he came in to the States not too long ago. Was it last week?
I came in last week, actually, from customs. Actually, my wife bought some... I'll page perfume on the boat, and I kept it in my pocket so that when I got to the customs, I wouldn't have to undo the cases. And when I got to the customs, I didn't have it. I don't know whether I dropped it or have my pocket pick. It's got to be worried.
Mr. Perry, in all this time, have you succeeded in lifting something from John?
No, not yet.
Why, should I still do that?
Well, Mr. Perry, thank you very much. It's been great having you.
Your book.
In just a moment, we'll meet tonight's mystery guest. But first, let's listen to Dick Stark with a word from Remington Rand.
Good evening. You know, in 10 or 12 hours from now, you gentlemen in our audience will be shaving again. Now, what kind of a shave will you get tomorrow morning? Will it be as fast a shave as you'd like? Will it, for example, be as fast and as clean as the shave our friend Jim Congdon here is getting with his man-sized Remington electric shaver? Brother, look at those whiskers come off. You know, only the Remington can make this fast shave demonstration on television because only the Remington is man-size. It has three extra-long, diamond-honed shaving heads. That's more live shaving area. Means a good, clean shave. Up to 8 times faster than the old-fashioned wet shave method. Much faster than any other shaving method, wet or dry. And look what a clean shave it gives you, too. The Remington shaves so clean... it can actually shave the short, close fuzz off a peach. Now, here the guard has been removed so that you can see the peach fuzz fall. And the Remington shaves that peach without ever harming its tender skin. So, friends, for a fast, clean Remington shave, pick up a Remington, won't you? You'll find most dealers offer the 14-day free trial plan. And, by the way, be sure you bring in your old standard make electric shaver. It's worth up to $7.50 as a trade-in allowance, and that is 50% more than anyone else offers. So... make your next shave the one shave that's fast and clean. Give yourself a peach of a shave with a man-size Remington electric shaver. You'll find out why Remington has made and sold more than 15 million electric shavers, more than any other make.
Now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which my friends are blindfolded. The blindfolds are all in place, panel?
Mm-hmm. They are, yes.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? In the case of our mystery challenger, we change the form of questioning a bit. You ask one question at a time in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin it all with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Are you Duke Snyder?
Are you Duke Snyder? That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Lewis.
I didn't hear the answer.
No.
Who answered?
I did.
Well, why?
You want to hear the real one answer?
Sure. Yes.
Would you answer the question, please? Are you Duke Snyder?
Mm-mm.
Lewis.
Well, just to clear it up once and for all, could we have seen you on television earlier today?
Miss Francis?
Boy, I wasn't around earlier today. You meant the series.
Yeah.
No, but it isn't a man.
There has been no call for a conference.
No, all right, all right. I'm terribly sorry. Are you engaged in the entertainment world? Mm-hmm.
Mr. Sir?
Are you, and I hope you are, a lady? By that I mean of the female persuasion.
Yeah, I think so.
Miss Kilgallen?
Are you in the motion pictures?
Mr. Lewis?
And you are also in television and... let me rephrase my first question, because this got an unusual answer. Could we have seen you on television earlier today?
That was it. Mm-hmm. That
Ms.
was the
I still don't understand the answer.
Only now it's not a ball player. I don't think. Are you here in New York just for the World Series?
No.
2008 to go, Mr. Sir.
Have you a husband who is possibly just as well known as you are?
Yeah.
Miss Kilgallen?
Have you ever made any records where you sang?
No.
3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Lewis.
But I did see you earlier on television today. Very good. Should I disqualify myself, John? Because this ridiculous question, I disqualify myself. I know who it is.
Take a guess.
I know who it is.
Well, say it. That's what you're...
The world's greatest comedian, Lucille Ball. I don't know.
Is that right?
Mm-mm. I almost hit my nose.
That
it's
makes
not...
it 4 down and 6 to go, Miss.
You sure it's not Duke Snyder?
Not Desi Arnaz. You say that you're married. Is the man that you're married to also in the picture business?
Yeah.
Sir?
Can I take a wild guess? Probably not.
Sure.
Are you Lorraine Bacall?
Lorraine, oh, for heaven's sake, there you go. 5 down and 5 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Are you the voluptuous blonde type?
I don't think so.
Okay, 6 down and 4 to go, Mr. Lewis.
Are you sure I saw you on television?
Yeah, I won't let that count as a question,
all
but
right,
you are reassured.
You. Do you have anything to do with the program, with the Lucy show?
Mm-hmm.
Miss Francis?
It's not Desi Arnaz. You're on I Love Lucy? Mm-hmm. I mean, is that the question that Bob just asked?
Yes. Well, the question was, do you have anything to do with the I Love Lucy show?
She doesn't sound like a stagehand. Are you Lucy's girlfriend? Mm-mm.
6 down and 4 to go, Mr. Sir.
If I... Both of them.
We didn't hear Desi at all.
Yeah, that was me.
That was you.
When?
Yeah.
Which one was that? That's what made it
she
so much fun.
She was the Swedish one, and I was there, mm-hmm.
And you see,
Swedish.
Swedish.
Swedish. Well, you had some kind of an accent, didn't you?
Yeah.
What? Swedish?
Swedish.
What is Swedish?
Cuban sweet.
Cuban sweet.
But it was very funny,
is that a dirty trick?
Yeah,
I'm sure you don't mind it. Because one reason, actually, that Desi and Miss Lucille are here is tomorrow night's a happy night when you all come back for the new season at 9 o'clock.
Yeah, but that's not really the reason. The reason is that we love you so very, very much. And every time we get to New York, we love to visit with you.
Oh, that's nice
very
of you to
sweet.
Say.
Well, were you on television today?
What, yeah, darling?
Were you on television today?
Sure.
Briefly,
yeah,
Ed Sullivan.
We just went over and took a look at Ed's show.
You were on at 6 o'clock New York time.
Oh, that's right. The Lucy Sunday show. It's
very
show.
Funny. Watch
that's
it sometime. Right. It's very funny.
The Lucy show. CBS on Sunday. That's what I thought was the only clue that Bob had.
Were you know, being the nearest one to you, I usually spot it when there are two people on. But
oh,
tonight...
How?
Well, I hear the two different voices, but tonight I was full completely.
I thought maybe you looked down at the seat.
It's possible, yeah.
No, as Mark Goodson, I think, proved last night on something, he works only with shows where you can't see anybody's feet. That's what he said.
Sounded like Betty McCall at the beginning. It sounded just like her with that.
Well,
I like that.
I must say this, I speak for all of us. We had a wonderful time when you visited us last time, and we've had as much fun this time, and we hope that you come back and see us again.
Thank
next
you.
Year, same time.
Wonderful
time,
to
same
see
station.
You both. Will you go and say hello
next
to the
next year, we'll bring both of the kids next year.
All right, good.
Good deal. Nice to see you. Good night. Good night, put it all in one or two words, very nice people. I always have been. We'll be back in just a moment, but first, here is a word from Remington Rand.
Friends, I'd like to take that moment to talk about Remington's 14-day free trial plan, if I may. Now, I know that once you've used the Remington electric shaver, the man-sized Remington, for 2 weeks, you will never be satisfied with the old-fashioned wet shave method or with any other electric shaver, for that matter. But to back up our confidence in Remington, we'd like to make this guarantee. The Remington electric shaver must give you a shave that's fast, clean, better in every way than your old method, or it won't cost you a single cent. Now, surely there's an offer that makes it imperative you try it for the best shave you ever had. Stop in tomorrow at your dealers. Won't you? Most dealers offer the 14-day free trial plan, so ask for it. Ask to try that peach of a shave, the Remington shave.
And now, before our panel says goodnight, may I remind you to tune in again next Sunday at 10:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Saving Time, when once again we invite you to play What's My Line. For other localities, particularly with these mix-ups in time these days, check your local listings for the date and time of our weekly series. And now, a word from next week's sponsor.
Now you can be one big happy family. Just stop snitching your wife's deodorant. Join active men everywhere who have started using new Mr. Stop-It for men. Applied daily, the manpower in Mr. Stop-It keeps you dry, prevents odor, can't harm clothes. And what a swell He-Man aroma. Get your house this special Mr. and Mrs. Family combination, Mr. Stop-It and regular Stop-It. You get both squeeze bottles, a regular $1.20 value, for only 98 cents plus tax. Why not get yours tomorrow?
And now, until next week, this is John Daly saying good night, Miss Dorothy.
Good night, John. And may I tell the girls in the audience that Lucy's blouse was pink mink?
Pink mink?
Come next week. Bye-bye.
Good night, Dorothy. May I tell the men in the audience, Desi's tie was blue. Good night, Arlene.
Good night, Bob. We'll see you again next week.
I hope so.
That's fine. Good night, Bennett.
Good night. Before I say good night to John, I want him to explain to me sometime how that Mr. Perry's weight had anything to do with his being a pickpocket.
Because he's so heavy and yet he's doing something so delicate. See, there is a juxtaposition that makes it more interesting. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. And thanks for being with us on What's My Line.
Transportation for What's My Line is arranged through American Airlines, America's leading airline, serving 77 major cities throughout the United States, Canada, and Mexico. This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production in association with the CBS Television Network.
Time now for everybody's favorite guessing game, What's My Line? Throughout the world, only one company produces all types of business machines and systems, Remington Rand, who now invites you to play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television who just...